I'm always excited when new integrations come out for the tools that we love, especially when those integrations introduce us to new tools that allow us to do more powerful things than ever before. In this video, I'm going to be showcasing for you a new integration for SmartSuite, now connecting to a tool called Relay. Relay is an incredible automation tool that puts human in the loop with automation. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and here at Gap Consulting, it's our mission to help you to get organized and automated with no-code tools. Now, one of our favorite no-code tools is SmartSuite. We especially love it for task planning and all that goes along with project management. But in this video, I'm going to be sharing with you how SmartSuite has recently announced their new integration with a tool called Relay. We're going to be walking through setting up an automation in Relay so that you can see how it works and how it might differ from the automation tools that you are accustomed to. But before I get started, I want to first invite you to join me for some free automation training. If you're new to automation, or if you need a refresher, this training will teach you those key fundamental building blocks so that you can start doing more in less time. Check out that training at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. I'll include links wherever you found this video. And I want to encourage you to follow along with me during this video. Go ahead and open up SmartSuite and Relay on your own screens. If you don't already have accounts, consider using our links. Again, wherever you found this video, we will share those, and you can get set up on free trials of your own using those links. Without further ado, hopping on in. Inside of my SmartSuite, I'm starting off real simple here. I just have tasks. Now, as I mentioned already, we love SmartSuite for task and project management. And so here I've built this scenario where I've got these different task names. They're all assigned to me because I don't want to bother anyone on my team just yet. They have different priorities, they have different status, etc. Now the due date inside a SmartSuite, it always flashes red if a task is overdue. And that's only true in the case where the status is not yet completed, right? So inside of the status, again, if you're newer to SmartSuite, we can go in and set when is something completed. And just by toggling this little radio button here, it can tell SmartSuite, hey, when they reach this certain status, it's no longer overdue. And so here we have complete. And so we can simply say complete, and we are going to notice an update here on the due date. And it's going to tell us, hey, this was completed after the due date. One of the reasons that I absolutely love SmartSuite for task management. But you might notice I also built a task overdue formula. What is happening over here? Well, I've gone into my advanced editor and I've said, if two conditions are simultaneously true, then I want you to output overdue. Now this could look like a lot all at one glance, so let me break it down. This little component right here that I'm highlighting, this is the and condition. Both of these things must simultaneously be true. In that condition, in that case, then we will say this is overdue. So what are those two conditions? The first one is status not equal to complete. If you're newer to formula syntax, this might look a little weird, but what we're saying is the status field, that is the status of any of these tasks, is not currently complete. Now, the other condition is that the due date of the task is less than this moment in time, now. If both of these conditions are not simultaneously true, that is to say, the status is not complete and the due date is less than this moment in time, well, then we know that this task is overdue. So then we want to say overdue on this formula. And that's all it's doing. Now, if we want to see it in action, you've probably already noticed that it's flashing overdue right here. This particular task is due on December 8th. As of recording this video, it is December 11th. So anything marked before December 11th that is not marked complete is going to show overdue right here. Now, once we move this one to complete, even though it was December 7th, well, then the overdue was removed because it's no longer overdue. It's now complete. So if we were to change the status here to complete, this formula will recalculate and tell us that, hey, even though this thing was completed after the due date, it's no longer overdue. This formula is going to be used as a trigger in our automation that we build inside of Relay. But first, Let's flip on into Relay and take a look at that first automation. So here I am inside of my brand new Relay account. I have spent less than 1 hour inside of here. And this is why I go back to what I said at the beginning of this video. If you understand the key fundamentals of building no-code automation, it does not matter what tool you are using. Relay is no different from many of the other tools in so many different ways. Automations function the same way. Again, grab that training if you haven't already. But here inside of our Relay automation, the beginning is our trigger. And our trigger is, let's flip in here, when a task inside of our SmartSuite table flashes overdue. So we are watching that formula that we wrote and we're saying when it becomes overdue, then we want to trigger the automation. Fantastic. What do we want it to do? Well, those are the actions that we build into our automation. And this is what I think is really unique about Relay as a tool. It allows humans to be a part of the loop of the automation. And so here we've actually gathered some data input as our very next step in the automation. And what I'm doing is I'm sending this to myself. I'm assigning it to me and I'm saying, hey, is this task something you wish to send to Slack? And what we can do is actually add information from the trigger. So let's bring in data from the trigger, and we can say the task name that we pulled from the original step in our automation. So here we go. We're asking ourselves, double check this. Is this something you want to do? And we are requiring some sort of output from ourselves before we proceed with the automation. And so we have a proceed toggle, and we're going to default the toggle to yes, but we're going to require that if it's marked no, we're not going to do anything else after this. Only if this person says, yes, this is something I want to do, are we going to move forward. So what does that look like? We've added two different paths. We have path A and path B. Path A, you'll notice we've set a condition that only in the case where the proceed was marked yes, that is the output that we gathered right here. If we said that we want to move forward with the automation, then we're going to send a reply to our Relay test channel inside of Slack. The message is going to come from me and it's going to say, hey, here's an overdue task. Here's the name. In the case where no path is selected, we have no steps in our automation. We're done. So basically what we've done is we've said the automation is going to trigger, but we're going to gather some human input first before we move on. Are we sure we want to move forward with this? If so, cool, we will, and we'll follow path A. If not, no problem, we'll follow path B, which essentially means the automation stops. So now that we've explained what the automation looks like, let's take it out for a spin. Over here, inside of our tasks in SmartSuite, I'm going to move one of these due dates back. Let's make this one due the 6th of December. What will this do when I save it? Well, it's going to say overdue here in our tasks overdue formula. And now if I flip into Slack, I'm going to see some cool stuff. Here I am inside of Slack, and if I look at my activity, the first thing you'll notice is that I received a notification from the Relay app. Relay has been integrated with my Slack, and so I now have this notification that just came a moment ago from Relay. And it's saying, is this task something you wish to send to Slack? And it's saying thing two. Why is it saying thing two? Well, coming back here, thing two is the name of the task that just flipped into overdue. So it's telling us, is this one that you want to send as a reminder? And now I can choose one of two options. But I want to point out first that the automation is waiting for my input before it does anything else. It is now in this pause cycle, and only when it receives input from me on this particular instance will it continue. So I have an option. I can open it in Relay, but I prefer to just do it right here in Slack. Let's fill out the form. And here's what it's going to tell me. Remember, we named a variable proceed. We set a default to yes, but I can make a different choice here if I want. Maybe I say, no, I'm good. I don't want you to do anything. Submit. Nothing else happens. The automation is now done. It will go down path B, which has no further actions, and it's completed its run. But let's take out a different opportunity. Let's say this one, thing one, we'll mark this as due on the 5th. This will be flashing overdue. I can then head on into Slack and I'll see the new message just received for thing one. Here it is. And I can fill out this form and I say, yes, you know what? Actually, I do want to send this. I want you to go down the next step of the automation. Let's keep that marked yes, submit. What happens next? Well, now when I flip into my channels, let's go home. And here I am inside of channel relay test. This is where we wanted that message to be shared. And you'll see that it was just shared. Overdue task thing one. Now I've only scratched the surface here. Obviously there's a lot more that we could do, a lot more data we could involve inside of our automations. But something that makes Relay unique is the fact that it is a per user pricing structure. So what does that mean? Well, here you see that at the startup mode, we can have up to 10 users paying $9 per user per month with unlimited playbooks, unlimited runs, unlimited automations, a lot of automation for only, what is that, $90 a month up to 10 users? Not too shabby. On the other hand, we have the unlimited plan here, which is for teams bigger than 10, and it's a flat $100 a month, regardless of how many users you bring on. Now, the thing that's really cool about this is that your users, when you're sharing your automations, they can just get access right there to the automation that was already built. Inside of the Relay automation, I can come in and add new users right here, new assignees to this automation. So now if I want to add a new role, let's just call this a test role and save. Now I can bring in new assignees for that particular scenario. So all the different members on my team who have access can be brought in to participate in all the different automations, making it so, so seamless for me to roll out automations and SOPs across my team. This is really interesting in the way that it's gonna change and reshape automation in the no-code space. So let me know in the comments below what kind of things you're curious about and how you're considering using Relay in your SmartSuite integrations. That's it for this video. In the meantime, keep on building.